We ask you to please remain seated so all can see the processional of graduates. Thank you.
I would like our senior members to
choir to come, please. At this time, would you please stand as the senior members of our vocal music sing our national anthem.
Spritea Beard, and John Ansel. Congratulations to you. Good afternoon. It's my privilege to announce our top 10 students from the class of 2018. When I read your name, will you and your parents please stand? Jaden Wren Johnson, daughter of Randy and Linda Johnson. Megan Christine Cachette, daughter of Tracy and Chris Cachette. Olivia Ryan Lowry, daughter of Ralph and Brenda Lowry. Paige Lauren Hawkins, daughter of Doug and Karen Hawkins. Allison Marie Simons, daughter of Jeff and Andrea Simons. Sophia Bell Wilhoyd, daughter of Stephen and Tamara Wilhoyd. Alexander Joseph Guido, son of Christopher and Kristen Guido. Emily Ruth Howe, daughter of Shannon and Christina Howe. Salutatorian for the class of 2018 is Kristen Nicole Larrick, daughter of John Lee and Ruth Larrick. And the valedictorian for the class of 2018 is Lily Bernadette Kackmar. Congratulations.
I have the honor of introducing our commencement speaker today. Colonel Billy Burse, U.S. Army, was born and raised in Macon, Missouri. He is a 1969 graduate of the Macon High School and 1973 Reserve Officer Training Corps honor, and distinguished military graduate of Northeast Missouri State University. Upon graduation with a Bachelor of Science degree, he was commissioned as second lieutenant in the U.S. Army. During his 26 and a half year military career, Colonel Burse commanded units at company, squadron, battalion, and brigade levels. He also served with infantry, armor, signal, airborne, special forces, and special operations forces. He is a decorated combat veteran and served during the Operation Urgent Fury at Grenada, Embassy Evacuation and Rescue Operations in Peru, and Operations Desert Shield, Desert Storm, and the Defense of Kuwait, where he commanded a battalion of 750 soldiers and 3rd Armored Division. His awards and decorations include the Defense Superior Service Medal, the Legion of Merit, Bronze Star Medal, Master Parachutist Badge, and some 35 total commendations, badges, and campaign awards. Upon retirement from the Army, Colonel Burse returned to Macon and started a consulting company, Dynamic Technology Research. He served as President and Chief Operating Officer for 15 years after his retirement in 2014. Colonel Burse is a graduate of the U.S. Army Command and General Staff College, U.S. Army War College, and numerous Army Leadership, Technical, and Engineering schools. He holds a Master's of Public Administration from Shippensburg University of Pennsylvania. Colonel Burse has 2 children, 2 grandchildren, and is engaged to Mary Julie Tooley, a retired 5th grade teacher. It is my pleasure to introduce to you Mr. Billy Burse.
Thank you.
It is indeed a pleasure to be here with you on this very special occasion. Let me say right up front how proud I am of each and every one of you graduating today. What a great accomplishment we celebrate here. Being here today brings back many special memories for me. Close your eyes and see if you can relate to some of these. Go ahead, close them, that's okay. I can hear teachers lecturing and professing and students answering questions. I can hear the band playing as it echoes through the hallways. I can see and hear fellow students and friends talking and laughing in the hallway. I can hear the school choir singing a familiar song. I can smell the, my favorite, I can smell the fresh cut grass on Friday night before a football game under the lights on Hugh Dunn Field. I can hear a basketball bouncing on the gym floor and a chant by the cheerleaders during the ball game. I can smell spring in the air during a track and field game. Remembering all the friends made and the teachers, coaches, and staff that invested in each student's future year after year. Now you can open your eyes. All of you. These and many other wonderful memories have stayed with me for 49 years. Yet, it seems just like yesterday. I hope you too have lasting memories of your time at Macon High School. Today, I'm only going to speak for about 12 minutes. I know it's hot in here. During that time, I want you to remember three areas of advice. During that time, correction. You will be tested. Oh, yes. One more. You will be tested, but not until you leave here today and you begin a new journey. No matter where you go or what you do, you will be tested every day. If you listen and take my advice, you will have a better, more successful life. I guarantee it, so listen closely. The first advice I want you to remember is that you are all writing a book. That's right. It's your autobiography. You started when you were born. By now, each of you probably have four, five, or perhaps six chapters in your book. If you relocated, then there's a chapter right there. But your first chapter is probably when you were young, your second chapter, elementary school, your third chapter, intermediate school, your fourth chapter, high school. And you may have some more chapters in there, special periods in your life. For me, when I served in the Army, I moved 17 times. That's 17 chapters in my book, totaling today 38 chapters. Each and every chapter of your book should be considered a new adventure unlike any other you have experienced before. For you, today is the end of a chapter. Tomorrow is the beginning of a new chapter and a great adventure. At no other time in your life do you have so many options on where you can go, what you can do, and who you can become. You can move anywhere you want to move. You can continue your education, learn a new trade, join the armed forces, or enter the workforce. Just look at all the choices you have. I know it may be a bit overwhelming, but take time to examine all the possibilities. Make a plan, develop a strategy, set goals, and go after it. The second area of advice I want you to think about is, what is a successful life? Let me first tell you what is not a successful life. Making an abundance of money and becoming rich is not a successful life. Don't misunderstand me. It is important to have a solid financial base in your life, but too many people just don't get it. Making a lot of money alone does not make you a respected or successful person. What kind of a person you become and how many people's lives you touch in positive ways largely determines your level of success in life. How hard you work, your work ethic, your honesty and integrity, your character, how you treat others, expressions of kindness, and helping those in need are parts of who you become. Common sense and being intellectually smart is a large part of success. One without the other spells failure. It is never too late to be educated and to learn. It is a lifelong process, expected to be. Whatever profession you choose in life, be the best that you can be. Don't measure yourself against others. Measure yourself against an existing stated standard or you yourself. These are important parts of success. What do I mean by touching others' lives? Here's an example. I know we have a lot of teachers here today. I would ask, how many teachers have become financially wealthy by becoming a teacher? But we know the answer to that. None. However, how many teachers have touched hundreds, if not thousands, of people's lives in their teaching profession? We also know the answer to that. All the lives they've touched, folks, this is success. Whether you realize it or not, the teachers, coaches, and staff at Macon High School have made a huge investment in you and your future. Did you know that a teacher's greatest reward is a former student telling them, thank you for helping me. Thank you for not giving up on me and investing in my future. Let me encourage you before you leave here today to thank a teacher, a coach, a staff member for everything that they've done for you, for touching your life. Whether you are successful or not has much to do with your network of family and friends. You needed them to make it here today. You'll need them in your journey ahead, and perhaps more than you realize right now. Very few accomplishments in life will be solely you, like a diploma where your name is the only one stated. There are many family members, friends, teachers, and others who have supported and helped you in your achievement. Don't forget those who helped along the way. Whatever profession you choose and type of person you become, you should study hard, have a passion for your work, help others, hold the door open for someone. Thank a veteran, you will make their day. Join a service organization. Help serve in a food line for the homeless. Coach a kid's sports team. And I could go on, but you get my point. Pay back and pay forward the abundance of good fortune and many blessings you yourself have received. You are lucky. Then you realize this is a successful life. Reach out and touch another person at every opportunity. My third area of advice consists of three simple words: attitude, attitude, and attitude. Life is all about attitude. I know you've heard a lot about attitude. I'm going to tell you what it is right now. Here are the most important things you need to know about attitude. It's yours, you own it, and you have control. You can choose to have a bad or good attitude every day of your life. However, let me warn you now, others will intentionally or unintentionally try to influence your attitude. Sometimes events will influence your attitude. These are considered outside influences. Attitude is infectious. It can spread to others, whether it is good or bad. Here's an example of what I mean about attitude. Imagine you are in the classroom only a few days before graduation. Your teacher just announced that by Monday, you are to write a 1,000-word essay paper on your plans for the future. Your first thought is, I thought I was done with this. Suddenly, here comes that outside force wanting to influence that great attitude you had just had seconds before you heard the words, 1,000-word essay, do. Here's a suggestion of how to shed the bad attitude that has suddenly taken your entire mind and body over. Say to yourself, this is attitude shock that only lasts a few seconds. Gee, I was really hoping for a 2,000-word essay due tomorrow. Ha! Learn to laugh at yourself and learn to repel those outside forces that want to bog you down. You can't do anything about the required essay, so don't whine. Whining is an expression of a bad attitude. And don't you just hate whiners? I do. Great leaders know how to influence attitudes for the betterment of people and the organization. Become a leader and learn how to influence attitudes. Remember, you have complete control of your attitude. In conclusion, my three areas of advice for you. Number one, you are writing a book of your life that includes many chapters. Every chapter begins as a great adventure, a new start in life. Enjoy the journey. Number two, what's a successful life? You should now be oriented in the right direction on what success is really all about. Number three, those three simple words, attitude, attitude, and attitude. You have control. Make the best of it. When you wake up in the morning and you turn, pivot, and place your feet on the floor, realize you are beginning a new chapter in your life, a great adventure. Success awaits you. And then tell yourself, I'm going to have a great attitude today, no matter what. I'm going to be kind to others, and I'm going to touch as many lives as I can because I want to be successful. Successful in life. Congratulations on your graduation today. Good luck in your new adventure. Be safe, and I wish you many blessings in the journey ahead. Thank you.
First off, let me give my warmest congratulations to the class of 2018. You're a talented and a hardworking crew. I am very proud to have been your principal during your senior year. Thank you all for coming today to the graduation ceremony. Seeing graduates, parents, family, and friends and staff here today is a testament of the achievements of the graduates and the love and support they have received over the years from you. Today is the fun part. However, the past few years, the teaching staff have seen the graduates work exceptionally hard. They are the lucky ones who have had the privilege of helping you with your educational growth. Also, we have watched your parents, your family, and your friends support you with everything that you have accomplished. Every graduate here today has worked very hard to make the best of themselves. You have persevered and worked towards your goals in a determined way. Each of you has grown in a way that you should be very proud of. You arrive here at graduation, a skilled and valuable group, all ready to tackle the next set of challenges, which will ensure you to grow further. You are all a credit to yourselves. The students, faculty, administration, and the community have taken great pride in the multitude of successes that you have accomplished. Class of 2017, you have made the Macon community extremely proud. The future holds many challenges and successes for each of you. Each of you have your own unique opportunities to grow, and I am confident you will rise to every occasion. Let me wish you all the best for the future, and thank you again for being an exemplary group of students to work with. Mr. Wyatt, would you please come forward? Mr. Wyatt, board members, members of the Board of Education, I am pleased to present 2018 class of Macon High School. These students have met all requirements set forth by the Missouri Department of Education and the Macon County R1 School District, and therefore entitled to receive their diplomas.
Wayne Busher. Megan Christine Kashak. Lauren Elizabeth Chambers. Bailey Jo Cox. Braylon Hilario Diaza. Braden Rain Dowell. Anthony Duncan. Emily Nicole Elliott. Denise Britt Farley. Sarah Lynn Flowers. Me, Lauren Fry. Jose Francisco Garcia. Ryan Andrew Gibson. Kale Campbell Grant. Audrey K. Greenwood. Tucker Western Gresham. Noah Harrison Grandma. Macy Jade Harrington. Paige Lauren Hawkins. Allison Ann Hayes. Liv Ashton Heaton. Cade Garrett Hicks. Tyrone Lee Hicks.
Hey, look, mama made it.
Emily Ruth Howe. Johnson. Seth Ryan Jones.
Bridget Leanne Ford.
Jacob Brendan Prim.
Alexander Joseph Guida.
Joshua Aldo Ratley.
Megan Grace Rector.
Shelby Ann Riley.
Sean Lee Roberts.
Mildred Rodriguez Salazar.
Jack Allen Rose.
Kendrick Michael Rupp. Maxwell Gannon Schrader.
Jordan Lee Senholz.
Dakota Wade Sewell.
Allison Marie Simons.
Jeffrey Brian Smoot.
Nisal So.
Taylor Paige Still.
Carly Jean Switzer.
Cameron Christine Thrasher.
Miranda Paige Ward.
Aaron Michael Wick.
Cole Andrew Wilson.
Elizabeth Wilt.
Yeah. Michael Wood.
Colton Michael Yaunt.
Marissa Dawn Seabart.
Kristen Nicole Lyric. Lily Bernadette Kakmar. Seniors, this afternoon, family and friends have gathered here to celebrate a major accomplishment in your lives. As we bring close to your high school career, new doors are opening that will bring you new opportunities. We wish you the best of luck as you look to the future. I would ask at this time for the seniors to move their tassels to the left side to signify completion of their high school careers. This concludes our ceremony. Congratulations.